There's him.
November 10th.
work until we're done. Plan most of your day. Bring some snacks because we have to eat more while we're working.
Right click.
And then hopefully as we get stuff done, then we can decide if we need to plan another one. But we usually do a pretty good job of getting that done that first day. So ladies and girls, we would love to have you join us. And we actually do make a card of those rooms. Okay, Matt. I think he's doing it on purpose.
We had a big 12 out for our rich breakfast on Saturday. So thank you guys for there. We even had a lady there, her little granddaughter, Marie. Rich can't go anyplace without his wife. She kind of.
Okay, so those of you who are interested in going to DFL next year, our women's conference, that is absolutely fantastic. We have decided to make that easier on even me. To save a little bit of money, we're going to do some fundraising. You can actually earn enough to pay for your entire ticket. The rest of the money that is earned, we'll figure out how to distribute that as we go along. But who doesn't like candles? Amen. I love candles. And Christmas is coming up. You've got teachers. You've got bosses. So this is a perfect way to do a lot of your Christmas shopping and help out the ladies. We're kicking off today. Right now it's telling us that our end date is the 12th. Which is not far away. We're going to work on getting that changed. But if you're interested, come see me this morning. We'll get a packet filled out. Remember too, JBQ is also going to be selling this. So you can sell for you and then maybe buy one from the kids to help out with the junior Bible quiz. But if you have any questions, I'll be here. I'm always here till at least 1 o'clock because we have to get everything set up in the back. So. Come see me. I'll be up here at the front. I'll get your packets handed out. We can talk a little bit about it. Any questions or issues, you can always see me. Okay? Thanks.
All right. Then,
I believe the last note was Living Nativity. And that's coming up the 7th, 8th, and 9th of December. First weekend of December. We do our Living Nativity out there for 3 nights. It's powerful. We had like 1,400 go through it last year. Beautiful weather, great crowd, walk through, and it's all dramatized and beautiful. And we need your help. So my wife's going to come up and explain everything to you, especially you that have never seen this or been a part of it, maybe driven by and seen it all lit up there at Christmas last year. We've been doing it about 9 or 10 years now. And each year it just amazes us, the response that we get.
Before I say anything, we need to give the guys in the sound booth a big hand. They arrive on Sunday morning and do all these last minute changes, last minute things, and they work miracles, believe me. So I'd just like to thank them for getting things ready. We had some changes to make in this, and they accomplished it. Wonderful. Yes, the Nativity is coming up. It's that time of the year again. Can you believe it? Still back at summer, I think, somewhere. But anyway, just so you have an idea of what's going on, some of you are new and have never been to the Nativity before. So is that video ready to go? We're going to see that first, and I'll talk to you a little bit. Okay.
Receive her gift.
time where kids can come, people can come and pet and feed the animals. Is this one?
Yeah.
Okay. They do take home crafts that they can, usually an ornament that they can hang on the tree. And remember each year, there's lots of cookies and hot chocolate they enjoy. There's photo stations where they can take pictures. There's a little presentation here in the auditorium too. I'll have this information back on the bulletin boards, but the dates are 7, 8, and 9. For those that are helping, we provide dinner for you every night. Okay, so if you're here by 5 o'clock, before it all starts, you can have dinner. We have something different for you every night. You get to eat before you come, before you go take the place and get into your stations, whether it's a costume or it's something else. And so we like the nativity costumes to go first so they can get all dressed and stuff like that. We have people helping you on that. We'll have this information back there. If you could be there by 5 o'clock, that'd be awesome. There's some work days that we need to do. One comment was, how do you get it done so quickly? Everything, it was like, it wasn't there, now it's happening. Well, it takes a lot of work and a lot of planning. So we do have some nativity work days, and I'll have these posted back on the bulletin board as well. Each Saturday, the men are going to be meeting here. There's all those props that have to be gotten out of the garage over there to be carried back in and be put in place wherever it goes. So each Saturday, starting next Saturday, and the 17th and 24th, starting at 9 o'clock in the morning, if you could be here to help, that would be a big blessing to us. The ladies, this Saturday, we need your help. It's going to be a work party. So we have all the costumes to iron and hang up and get ready. We have flyers that we passed out to the school last year. We did 10,000 flyers to different schools in the area. All those to get bundled up. We have lights to test and trees to fluff for the platform here for inside decoration in the church. There's just lots and lots of work to be done, and so we can use everybody's help. If you can make it here Saturday at 12 o'clock until however long you can stay. Also, on the 18th of November, Tisha would like to have as many people to stay and help to come decorate the church. And the foyer, the tables in the fellowship hall for our guests. And so if you can help us on the 18th Sunday, we'll have some pizza here for everybody. And if you can stay and help, that'd be a great blessing to us too, to get ready for that. I asked on the comments last year, how did you find out about the nativity? Because we always do comment card, because it's just interesting to hear the comments. So some of them, it seemed like every, because I was wondering, well, are all these different areas necessary? Do we need to put work and time and money into it? And it seemed like every area of advertising, we got people in from it. Some just drove by the church, they saw it on the marquee. They saw the advertisement on Joy FM website. They saw church signs all over the neighborhood. They saw it in the Advantage News, the Telegraph, the Facebook, the website. Some had came because of flyers from the school. So all those means of advertising, we got people in last year. I think Pastor said we had 1,400 people walk through in those 3 days, and I'm expecting even more this year. It takes about 70 of us all working together, including kids and adults, everybody. It's something, a family affair, church affair for everybody that can help. No matter how young or how old you are, we need you to help spread the real meaning of Christmas to our community. I asked what they liked best about the Nativity. One said, you took time to do it right. Another person said they liked Simeon's presentations. They liked feeding the animals. They liked the crafts. They liked the camels. They liked the donkeys. They liked that guy, all the guys talking. We had different ones talking and presenting different things. The love of Christ that we saw in you people. All of it. It was so organized. They liked the hot chocolate. They liked the gospel presentation. One said the hot chocolate was a perfect temperature. The other person said, more cookies, more cookies, more cookies. And what would they change? Somebody said nothing. Somebody said add more lights. We're going to try and do that this year. Add singers. They wanted sheep that talk. I don't know if we can do that. They wanted the kids all get a gift. We do crafts. They get to take home, but we'll see. They wanted to have a motion sensor to quote the scriptures as they're walking by, I guess, so they don't have to read them. But I don't know if we would make that happen or not. But it was just lots of fun. And some of the comments, they said, thank you for sharing the real meaning of Christmas with us. We love you all and appreciate your service. Thank you for sharing God's love with the community. It was awesome. And those are just a few of the comments that we had from the people that came through the Nativity last year. In the foyer, I'm going to have sign-up sheets. There'll be sign-up sheets for the food that we need for our workers. If you can donate some of that, we all put it together, just everybody giving a little bit, it just helps it to go a long ways. We also need, what'd I say, 200 dozen cookies. Yeah, that's a lot of cookies. You're figuring even 1,000 people. Well, if you're figuring 70 workers and even two cookies, which I know you guys eat more than two cookies, that's quite a few cookies right there, isn't it? With your cattle figure. So we need lots of cookies. And so if you want to make them ahead of time, a freezer, bring them in, whatever, that's something that all of us ladies can do. We like to have homemade cookies, but if you get in a pinch, you can't do that. We take the store-bought cookies too. People get those too. And so we'll have a sign-up sheet for the food to be donated. And then also, there'll be the sign-up sheet for all the characters and positions. So if you can help us out, have a look back there on the information desk and on the two tables at the back of the foyer, okay? Thank you so much.
Donkey in the Bible to talk, so maybe we can get some sheep to talk to. Petition to the Lord and see what happens there. So, you've given faithfully all the 23 years I've been here. Just never cease to be surprised and touched by the giving of this church, and not only for Bethel, but for the world. You've given and given thousands, literally over hundreds of thousands of dollars overseas to help in wonderful works there. And all that we thank you for, and appreciate a wonderful board that takes care of the finances. We've never had a problem all the years I've been here. In the 18 years Brother Brand was here before I got here, just running in harmony, just the beauty of the Lord, and we're blessed at Bethel. Amen. Amen. I hear horror stories and things that happen in other churches. I thank God we have not seen that at Bethel. And there's reasons for that. We build safeguards in every area of our ministry here so that in no way will we ever give the enemy a cause to blaspheme at Bethel. Amen. When they walk through those doors, they sense the presence of God, and they know we're standing for truth, godliness, and for God's presence. Amen.
Amen.
So we want to thank you for your giving. I'm going to ask the ushers to come right now. You give us, God has given you.
Worthy to be praised this morning. Guys, I just want to encourage you to lift your hands and worship.
The enemy is a real enemy.
Yes.
But we have a God, we have a King that is greater, stronger, that is mighty in battle. And when you can stand in your worship and your praise, you know who you are in Christ. We are sons and daughters of the living King. He is able to move mountains. So that's the stance that we come from this morning in our worship. And so I just want to encourage you to pray that you're blessed, and I pray that you are empowered to move throughout this week with the presence of the kingdom of God.
His love for me. In the sky.
Circumstances. Yeah. 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 our worship.
Yes.
When Joshua led the people around the Battle of Jericho seven times, we were talking this morning, they looked like fools. They were mocking at them, they were laughing at them, and they were just like, what are they doing? But their praise and the worship in the end caused the enemy to turn on themselves.
Yes. Yes.
That's why we worship.
Yeah.
That's why we praise. That's why we come from that stance of knowing who we are as sons and daughters of the living King.
Hallelujah.
He is good, y'all.
Yeah.
He is so good. And it's not dependent on us. It's depending on Him and us standing under Him.
Yes.
And knowing that it's because of Christ. So all the saints and angels bow before Your throne, and all the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God.
Thank you. A friend that sticks closer than a brother.
Hallelujah.
And I've seen God